In continuing with our election coverage, there's one ballot question in particular that's garnering a lot of attention with Miami-Dade County voters, whether or not to raise property taxes to pay for the construction of a much-needed courthouse. Earlier this month, we had Chief Judge Bertilla Soto on the program, who is in favor of raising that tax and building a new courthouse. However, one vocal critic claims the county has the money for a temporary fix to the aging building, while other options and existing locations can be considered. We welcome Miami-Dade County School Board Member Raquel Regalado, representing District 6. Raquel, good to see you.
Good to see you too.
So what is your, what are your key points of opposition to this ballot initiative?
Well, the first point is that the campaign has been disingenuous. The campaign is focusing on pictures of the building, and really this is not about fixing the building. This is about building a new courthouse. And if you look at the over $1 million that they've spent on this campaign, they have really confused the electorate to think that this money is going to go to fix a historic building. The second part is, even though they claim to have a plan, the plan has a lot of questions, and that's why they didn't even receive the Herald's recommendation on this. Everyone understands that the building has problems and that we need to fix those problems. But the first thing we need to deal with is, how did we get to this point? Because any of us that see these pictures wonder, how did this building get to this deteriorated point? And what's sad about this is that the people doing the campaign, the judges, are not the decision makers. The decision makers have been missing throughout this entire conversation. The county commission has not spoken. Last week, they tried, Commissioner Soto tried to bring an item to talk about other alternatives, and he got calls from the people that are running this campaign to leave that until after the election. And nobody wants to talk about other options. A lot of people don't understand that our judicial system is made up of 11 buildings, many of which are in very poor conditions. And even the reports that they claim put us at this place tell you that there's other buildings that have other issues. Now, is there a crisis at the building? That's another problem. And that gets to your point of, does the county have the money? The county has $78 million from the Building Better Communities bond money that has been sitting there since 2004. What people need to understand about what has occurred at that building is there was $18 million slated to fix it in 2004. That money was finally put into play not this July, last July. How did it take us that long if we have all these reports from 1988, from 2007, saying that something was wrong with the building? And we have to answer that question before we invest in a new building. The Children's Courthouse, which everyone, it was an agreement with, a courthouse that we're gonna be paying until 2042, just got its occupational license. And that's important because people need to understand that the county has a pattern or practice, and that this initiative is part of that practice. We don't know when they're gonna move into that courthouse, and yet we have no plans for the Lawson building, which is where they have been holding the family court. So now we're gonna have an empty building that we've invested millions of dollars in. The county can't tell you what they're gonna do with it, but they can tell you that it's gonna take the judges from 4 to 8 months to move into the new children's courthouse. So we're gonna abandon another building, we have a new courthouse. This plan wants to build a new courthouse and abandon a historic building.
But Raquel, devil's advocate, which is my job, you have no doubt that current courthouse, the civil courthouse, has to be fixed.
Of course, we all agree. And that's the other issue with this plan. They're planning on staying there 4 to 6 years. Only $25 million is gonna go to fix the columns. Yet the campaign has been talking about a sick building, has been talking about asbestos, has been talking about
it's
air
all
quality.
True.
Well, the issue is that they're planning
have you
on
been
staying.
There?
I've done the tour.
Okay,
the,
so then
the
you floors, know it's true.
The floors are closed. They have not asked the county for remediation. They have not put in money to fix those buildings, to fix the plumbing. So you're gonna stay in a building 4 to 6 years. You're not gonna fix the bathroom. You're not gonna fix the air conditionings. You're not gonna fix the mold. You're not gonna fix the asbestos. And when you ask them why that is, they say, well, in order to do those things, we would have to leave the building.
You're an attorney. You know that that courthouse, which is the same age as Vizcaya, was built in the late 20s, and it was designed for fewer judges and fewer. The county wasn't as large as it is today. You have 41 judges today. You have 23 courtrooms. It's outgrown, even if the building was perfect.
I agree.
It has completely outgrown its size. Agreed?
Agreed. And that's why I've been asking for a comprehensive plan. Different cities have made investment in these satellite courthouses that have never worked. They've never been used. We haven't talked about technology, about
but
the ability.
But you have to. But that's going to take an investment, too. I mean, there's no question that if you want to do satellite systems, which could work, if you want to do a satellite system, that's going to require a monetary investment too. The systems that currently, some of the proposed sites, Hialeah and so on, they don't have jury rooms, and the civil courthouse requires juries.
Right.
So those are the facilities that have to be reworked and revamped as well. The opposition would say that the building has to be fixed because it's a national landmark, and so it's got to be fixed anyway.
Right.
When you were on Michael Putney's show a couple of weeks ago, you said that somebody should apologize, or I'm paraphrasing.
Well, I said that should be some accountability.
There should be accountability. There is no question that there should be accountability. Why do you think there hasn't been any accountability?
Because this gives the commission and the mayor a way out. Obviously, if you put the question on the ballot.
Commission, this
has been going on for a long time.
When you have air conditioner units that were put in when Dwight Eisenhower was president, I mean, this is a long time
ago. Right. I was on this show when we did the campaign for the bond. And one of the first things I told you was, in 1988, we did it wrong. And I explained what happened in 1988 and why we needed a bond and what had gone wrong and what we were changing at the school district so that it wouldn't happen again. I was in eighth grade in 1988. Obviously, I was not responsible for the decision made by that school board. But that doesn't mean that you don't have to own it and explain to people what happened. That hasn't happened here. And when we talk about investments, there are other cities that want to make an investment. Doral is willing to pay for a courthouse. We haven't had that conversation. There's other buildings that are available, and there are technology requirements that we are behind on. The state of Florida has already told the clerk of the courts that they are a year and a half behind on their technology mandate. Everything is being filed electronically, and yet these plans have square footage for storage. There's a disconnect here, and we have to have a broader conversation.
There is a plan that hasn't been approved by the county commission from 2008.
Yes.
This is not a new conversation. And it's not a new conversation for City of Miami officials either. As a matter of fact, the building is in such bad disrepair that on August 7th, the city issued a first notice for repair or demolish of the building.
The county has not responded to.
Which the county has,
But
let me tell you something. When I look at the way the city of Miami, which is responsible for the courthouse as it is for Vizcaya, treats the courthouse very differently. With Vizcaya, they are all over Vizcaya, to Vizcaya's great benefit, to improve it, to make sure that you have new sprinkler systems, the fire codes, the inspections of Vizcaya, constant and huge. And it's costly, but it's to the benefit of Vizcaya. That's not been the case of the courthouse at all. City of Miami has also been negligent.
The City of Miami has been meeting with the county. They've looked at the structural reports. Peter Iglesias has been great. The county has been asking for more and more time. Commissioner Zapata has an item to deal specifically with this and to have someone go in and do an inspection and to allocate the $78 million to make the changes.
There is a huge difference between the way the city treats Vizcaya and then the way the city treats the courthouse. And when you look at the volume of traffic between Vizcaya and the courthouse, it's not comparable. I don't want to have, and I don't think voters or you would want to have our judiciary with the need for jurors, because this is not about a building. This is not about attorneys. This is not about jurors. It's about jurors. It's about people having their due process in a building where you go there and you smell the foul air. When I've been there,
so why are
people
we gonna leave people there four to six years.
Well,
which is my point. How is that better in 4 or 6 years?
Well, because
they're gonna stay exactly under those conditions.
Because if you are going to build a new building, which is a possibility, I mean, there's no question that ultimately you have to agree.
There has to be other solutions. There's lots of things that we can do.
In the meantime, until you get there, if you can move it in a year's time or less, that would be ideal. But
they're not planning on it. 4 to 6, they're planning on staying in this building that they're saying is falling apart 4 to 6 years. And that's part of the problem. But we have to, in order to fix it, we have to take them out. So we have to have that conversation. And that's why I say that the campaign is disingenuous.
And I would agree. I don't think the campaign is disingenuous, but the solutions that any side is offering isn't complete.
Well, I think, and honestly,
because you're also just throwing ideas out in the air. You don't have a concrete solution either for the needs of this courthouse
At the end of the day, you know, if this fails, the county commission has committed to having a more comprehensive conversation. I've met with several commissioners about that.
But
this has a lot of moving parts. Why does it take chaos?
If it weren't for the fact that I am amazed, and thank God there hasn't been somebody hurt and that there hasn't been a lawsuit, because it's just an accident waiting to happen.
The issue is that we've tried to deal with it now, and the people who are running the campaign have stopped all those conversations at the county commission, which is very interesting. I was the first one to say, you know, now that this is on the ballot, now that the commissioners are aware of this, let's talk about it.
But why does it take a campaign like this that commissioners need to be aware of it? You see, why does this, the commission, I think that the city of Miami and the county commission and the mayors on both sides, with all due respect to your father, the city of Miami mayor, Tomas Regalado, have dropped the ball on this issue. And I just feel that I am not an attorney. I don't normally go to the courthouse. I'm just absolutely stunned that we have a courthouse, a civil courthouse, which is so important. When we were talking about the importance of judiciary with Judge Parente and our first panel.
But look, Judge Parente brought up a very good point.
And we deal with it as if it doesn't matter. And yet we have museums and a museum facility like Vizcaya, and God bless them, but it's just treated very differently.
You had the chief judge on your show. She went before the county commission and she said, this is not your fault. And afterwards she said, well, the commissioners that are sitting there, it's technically not their fault. Yeah, but that's not what voters want to hear. It is their fault. They're sitting there. They're the ones in charge.
They're the stewards of the public dollars. But I do believe that, you know, with the city of Miami saying repair or demolish, you can't demolish, but it is saying repair. The city has finally stepped up to the plate. Shouldn't the city have made this request of repair or demolish a long time ago?
And that's going to be part of the conversation that Zapata wants to have. What went wrong in this process? Why are we here? The city did uncover that the county has been lying in the computer records about the courthouse, not just about this courthouse, but also about the criminal courthouse. They had it slated as built in year zero. They had no information
on
there.
Was that not a typographical error? It built year
it's
zero.
It's interesting that only I agree with you, but we have the documents.
I mean, it would be different if you would say 1876, but year zero, somebody made, that's a technical error.
But at the same time, the county also had an obligation to send a list to the city. These buildings were not on that list. There's obviously a disconnect. There's lots of issues with the compact. But putting this on the backs of the voters is not the answer. And that's my point. And I think that now the commission understands, whether it happened the right way or the wrong way, that they need to find a solution. And not just a solution to this building. They need to find a solution to the criminal courthouse. We need to have a conversation about the jail. This last budget was balanced with $2 million from the Chrome Project. Judge Leisman's mental health facility has been slated for 10 years, and now it just happened because of this conversation with the
courts. There's a lot of blame to go around. Raquel Regalado, thanks so much for joining me today.
A pleasure.